So, today I'm going to talk about how you train your shoulders in the best possible way. I'm going to display five exercises for the perfect delt development. Your shoulders is a very visible part of your physique, and they should look like the pinnacles of your body. To get really prominent shoulders, you need to develop all your delts, including your front delts, also known as the anterior deltoids, your medial delts, which is also called the lateral deltoids, and your back delts, aka your posterior deltoids. I've been quite busy the last few weeks because I have recently moved to a new city. I have moved to Trondheim in Norway to start my master's degree in civil engineering and getting into a more bodybuilding specific training environment. I've been quite busy the last few weeks, but I'm back on YouTube now, hopefully doing at least 3 quality videos per month, developing my social media reach and increasing my target group on YouTube and Instagram will be a high priority in my everyday work. Therefore, I will be active posting content here on YouTube. Also, make sure to give this video a like, hit that subscribe button to help me develop my reach in the fitness community. So, all right, let's get on. Shoulders is one of the strong points in my physique. My shoulders are very developed, and I always look very lean when my shoulders are visible. Because of my natural body fat distribution, my delts are very ripped and the muscle separation is very visible. My vertical pressing strength is one of my stronger assets, looking at my strength level. I have good development of all my shoulder delts, and this is because I have trained shoulders properly over years. I've had a structured setup, train all delts in a convenient way. To get the real 3D look, you need to train compound and isolation exercises on all three delts. You want to train these from different angles and different movement patterns to work the muscles in a variety of ways. To develop a muscle group properly, you cannot only depend on one movement pattern. Therefore, I've set up 5 exercises you can perform to hit all shoulder delts in a convenient way. The exercises I have included are dumbbell shoulder presses, front delt raises, here executed by dumbbells, high dumbbell rows, side delt raises, and face pulls. This is only a suggestion for what exercises you can include working your shoulders. There are always other good exercises, but these are the exercises I particularly do for working my delts. I will recommend to have at least one shoulder day or upper body day a week where you really focus on optimizing your shoulder growth. You can set up a shoulder day like this. How often you do it will depend on the level of advancement. A beginner will likely make real results from doing this once a week. An intermediate should likely do this every 4 to 5 days, or have another day a week where he does some of these exercises. And an advanced athlete really aiming for high shoulder development could recover from doing this 2 to 3 times a week. You can set up your training like this for 2 short shoulder days a week. Everything is up to you, and your gains are dependent on the total amount of training load you induce to your muscles and how you recover from that. The prerequisite for muscle growth or hypertrophy is muscle tension, and you optimize your muscle tension by working a muscle with 30 to 60 seconds of time under tension. In other words, you grow most muscle from doing 8 to 25 repetitions doing a movement pattern that works a muscle in a way. When you do a work set, try to focus on the muscle and aim to control the eccentric. Your goal is to maintain tension in the muscle you are working. This is most safe, least fatigue accumulating, and most effective for inducing hypertrophy. I would also mention that push and pull movements train the shoulder delts to a significant degree. For example, you activate the front delt significantly from doing bench press and dips, and you activate your back delts from doing pull-ups and pull-downs. However, you need shoulder-specific compound and isolation movements to properly grow your shoulders. You need direct hypertrophy work for any muscle on your body. So, let's get on with the exercises. First exercise of the day is dumbbell shoulder presses. This is a vertical pressing exercise where you use your shoulders to push the dumbbells in a vertical line. Here you see me doing a work set of 15 repetitions. I will recommend to do this exercise with dumbbells. It is also possible to do it with a barbell, but in my opinion, dumbbells are much better to give your delts a free range of motion. Your shoulders get into a better position by moving free in the frontal plane. This means your shoulder delts are more activated when you load the movement with dumbbells, and this is better for hypertrophy compared to the military barbell press. As you see, here I focus on maintaining the tension on my front delts. I try to keep the load precisely over my shoulders to maximize the activation. Try to make the movement dependent on your front delts, not your triceps and traps. This is my set PR of 6 reps at 40 kg dumbbells earlier this month. Doing this exercise, I also want to bring the dumbbells down to my shoulders on the lower part of the lift. I see many people neglect that part and only do the top range of motion. I think you maximize your shoulder activation by bringing the dumbbells down to your upper chest. And here we go on the last reps. This is a true grind, and the exercise should be difficult on the top part of the range of motion. The second exercise I will present for growing shoulders is front raises. In my opinion, the superiorly most effective way to do this is doing it with one dumbbell at a time and going to a true failure. You could do this with 2 dumbbells or a barbell, but this will only create more momentum and limit the position of your shoulders. Using one dumbbell at a time will likely maximize the muscle tension in your front delts. You could also discuss that I'm using momentum from the eccentric, and I know many people are going to comment that I'm not doing this right. However, this is technical absolutism in my opinion. You only limit your delt activation by trying to control it excessively. Many people will claim they don't need this exercise because everybody has overdeveloped front delts. I still think most people need this exercise not only for hypertrophy, but also because this is very similar to the rotation movement in the bench press. Therefore, this exercise is transferable to your bench press strength. If you do bench press and overhead presses twice a week, you likely don't need this exercise, but I will always promote doing them for developing prominent front delts. The third exercise may come as a surprise to many. It's the back delt dumbbell row, which is a rowing movement to activate the back delts. The difference between this exercise and regular rows is that you row the dumbbell to the front of your shoulder and that you rotate your elbows outwards. Your starting point and ending point of this motion should be very high, obviously, as the exercise is also called high rows. The straight line movement contraction induces a major activation of the posterior deltoids. The most important in this exercise is to use the rear delts as the driving force to bring the dumbbells upwards. Whenever you have completed a set on one side, you do the same for the other side. Try to stretch the shoulder at the bottom in order to make it a full range of motion. You should try to keep constant tension on your posterior deltoid. The fourth exercise is the medial delt raise. Any variant of this exercise is actually the only exercise activating the medial or lateral deltoid of the shoulder, which makes it a lagging body part in every physique, not specifically focusing on isolation work on the deltoids. The middle delt of the shoulder is actually quite a neglected muscle group to work on for most people. It is actually close to impossible to activate it significantly without isolation work. You can either do this exercise by dumbbells or cable. I usually vary my loading method based on what suits me best. You want to bring the dumbbell or cable quite high. You should aim to get a slight rotation on your delt at the top of the lift. Also try to have your starting position slightly in front of your hips. This should make a full range of motion to work the medial delt fully. You could also do a more heavy variant with a shorter range of motion and more momentum, obviously with a higher load. However, I don't have them in my shoulder setup, but it is used as a common second exercise for medial delts by many athletes. The fifth and the last exercise of the day is face pulls. This is best done by a rope with cables and is working the rear delts in the same way as the back delt rows. Grab the ropes and step a few steps back. Your arms should be straight at the start of the movement. You want to get an internal rotation of the elbows in order to fully activate your delts. You get a contraction on your back delts by squeezing them together. Try to keep your legs straight the entire motion and minimize the use of momentum. Let your delt muscles control the entire movement. And there you have it. If you incorporate these 5 exercises to your shoulder setup and train hard, I can guarantee you are going to make progress. To get the real bodybuilder look, you need big shoulders, and in order to get that, you need real shoulder training. Train these exercises hard and repeat when they are recovered. Then I can guarantee you are going to get dominant shoulders. And hope you found this video helpful. Make sure to give this video a like to help my YouTube algorithm. Also comment down below, how do you train your shoulders? Do you do the same exercises as me? Make sure to subscribe to help me develop this channel to a bigger audience and to bring this information to more people. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Mixer Physique signing out.